Tonight I'm going to be cooking a stir fry. I'm going to be using a grass-fed organic ribeye steak. I don't eat beef very often. I usually only eat it once a month. So I had a taste for it, so I decided I'm going to go for it. So I've got my onions and garlic already in the pan. I'm going to add my beef so that it can start to caramelize along with the onions. One of the things that I do is I tend to put seasoning on my meat before I start to cook it. All I use is garlic and onions. And I let them sit with that for about 15 to 20 minutes, maybe 30 minutes, depending on how things are going. But as you can see, the meat is going to be cooking up very good and fast. We want it to be a little tender and a little red. Not too red, but enough so that it's still very, very tender. So the next thing I'm going to add will be my cauliflower. I like for cauliflower to be tender also, but I still like for it to have that crispy when I bite into it. So I should have probably broke this up a little bit smaller, but you will get the idea. This is a very easy meal to cook. And I'm using vegetables except for the cauliflower. Because my garden is on a balcony and I'm very limited into space, I don't grow my own cauliflower. I grow my carrots, which I'm going to be putting in next. It's time for me. I should have planted some more carrots because I am using up all that I have. So I'm putting these in so that they have a little bit of the flavor from the meat. And it smells good. I don't use any salt because I was diagnosed, or at least I had the symptom of sciatica back in December, and I'm recovering from it. So I don't claim it. I just say I'm going to eat the type of food that is going to make me healthy and stronger and allow me to renew my body, to make it stronger, and to strengthen it. Now, I have some broccoli. I'm going to put one in there just so you can see it. This came from my garden. This is my fourth time to receive a harvest from the broccoli plants that I have on my balcony. So, this is coming together very good. I'm going to try to keep it as fast as I can for you because I know when I'm watching other videos, it tends to... I tend to leave a lot of my vegetables long. I eat a lot of the stems. I don't know why, other than to tell you that I just figured if that's where all the nutrients were going up to the leaf or the vegetable. Got a lot in there. I have enough meat for two meals. So I'm trying to have enough vegetables, which are carbohydrates, to fill me up. But I rely mostly on my meat when I'm trying to do a recovery. That is something that I learned when I was working. I have now retired, but when I was working, I really needed the protein to do my job. So now that I'm not feeling 100% par, I'm back to saying, okay, I better do what I know worked for me before, because my God is a healer. He's healed me so many times. that all I need to do is continue to do what he has already shown me to do. So, everything but the meat and the onions. I do have some garlic, but I think most of my garlic is just about gone. I'm going to have to buy some garlic because I don't have a lot of room to grow everything. So some things I have decided to continue to buy, but my garden is a shade garden. I don't get very much sun, so I have decided that certain things don't grow that well. The leafy greens grow very well for me, all the way from lettuce to broccoli to kale, and this is Swiss char. So I'm cooking it now, and no salt because I had quite a bit of inflammation, and I have gotten rid of the inflammation now. There's very little of it left in my body. So I'm going to stick to trying to not add anything that is not good for me. I don't use any more sugar anymore. I kind of went overboard and was eating like some of my other family members. And diabetes really runs in my family. I have a brother that has lost both his legs to diabetes. My mother has diabetes, and I was considered pre-diabetic. I have a feeling that the doctor just looked at me and said my numbers are higher than they normally were, so I need to really work on getting them down. So I've been talking to you for quite some time. I believe it's just about ready. One thing that I do, and I'm going to do it now, I don't have any hot peppers, so I add... I spilt it all over my shirt, but I put crushed red peppers in there. I do grow bell peppers, and I put them in the, normally, but I only have one left, and I'm waiting on it to grow. So I put in the red and cayenne pepper. I'm going to do that because I don't use any salt. And I'm going today, I always add turmeric. That was one of the things that I added much more this time because of my inflammation. So I'm going to sprinkle a little turmeric in there. And I want the taste of ginger. So I'm going to put in ginger. Ladies and gentlemen, ooh, it smells so good. Oh, it smells so good. I wish you could have a taste, but I'm going to tell you, this is really easy. You watch me do it. I grow the vegetables that I can grow in my garden, and I've got enough now for a meal. So I'm going to say, may the Lord be with you. May the Lord's face shine upon you, and may the Lord keep you. But most of all, Heavenly Father, let the peace of God, which passes all understanding, mount guard over their heart and their mind. In your name, Jesus. Thank you for watching. I hope this has helped you to make a very healthy meal. I love you.